One of the milestones in the history of country music was Western Swing. This was a blend of old-time fiddle playing and black blues and jazz. The sound was developed and perfected by Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys.
Now listen, everybody from near and far, if you want to know who we are, we're the Texas Playboys from the Lone Star State. If you like the way we play, listen while we try to say, we're the Texas Playboys from the Lone Star State. And all day long, gonna sing this song.
No, Joe.
If you get this song,
of course you will.
You can't go wrong.
What?
And how we wear a smile, make things right, make it happy from morning till night. We're the Texas Playboys from the Lone Star State.
Bob was a self-taught fiddle player who knew how to make people happy, give them music they could dance to. Bob started in Texas with a group called the Light Crust Doughboy.
I got a gal, long and tall, sweet as she can be. What she got, nobody knows, but it goes all right with me. I'm crazy about Nancy Jane. I'm crazy about Nancy Jane. Oh, when she starts loving, she'll make a hit with me.
As the band's popularity grew from radio appearances, Bob formed his own band and got a job on KVOO in Oklahoma City in 1935. This is the band's first recording. It was called the Osage Stomp. In 1936, the following year, Leon McAuliffe made country music history with his brand new Rickenbacker steel guitar when the band recorded the Steel Guitar Rag.
Look out, friends, here's Leon. Take it away, boys, take it away. Oh, everybody dance now.
Bob's music continued to evolve and he added more horns. Then in 1940, Bob wrote words for one of his early fiddle songs.
Oh, that San Antonio Rose, yeah.
And made country music history with his recording of the new San Antonio Rose.
Deep within my heart lies a melody, a song of old. Where in dreams I live with the memory, beneath the stars all alone. It was there I found, beside the Alamo, enchantment strange as the blue up above. A moonlit path that only she would know, still hears my broken song of love.
The song was recorded by many others, including Bing Crosby, sold multi-million copies, and became a classic.
For that moonlit pass by the Alamo, and rose my rose of San Antonio.
You're listening to the original version of a song that made country music history. During World War II, there was a tremendous migration to the West Coast, everybody looking for their share of the good life. This hit recording from 1946 by Doy O'Dell says it all.
Oh, dear Okie, if you see Archie, tell him Tex got a job for him out in California. He's selling used cars, just a-waiting for the sucker. Oh, dear Okie, if you see Archie, tell him Tex got a job for him out in California. Picking up prunes, squeezing all out of olives.
Following the war, the popularity of country music grew by leaps and bounds in Southern California, principally because of all those immigrants. There were radio shows, country night spots, and starting about 1950, television shows. As we mentioned, one of the first country stars was Spade Cooley, who had his first hit in 1946 with
Shame, Shame on You. Shame, shame on you. Gave my heart as a token, when returned it was broken. Hide your face, shame on you.
Following year, his vocalist took some of Spade's band members and formed his own cooperative type band called the Western Caravan. They soon landed a contract with Capitol Records in 1947. Their first hit was written by Merle Travis. It was a smash.
Now, I'm a feller with a heart of gold, with the ways of a gentleman, I've been told. The kind of a feller that wouldn't even harm a flea. But if me and a certain character met, the guy that invented the cigarette, I'd murder that son of a gun in the first degree. Now, it ain't cause that I don't smoke myself, and I don't reckon they hinder your health. I've smoked them all my life, and I ain't dead yet. But nicotine slaves are all the same at a patent party or a poker game. Everything's gotta stop while they have that cigarette.
Smoke, smoke, smoke that cigarette. Puff, 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 and if you smoke yourself to death,
tell St. Peter at the Golden Gate that you hates to make him wait, but you just gotta have another cigarette.
World War II was a fertile period in the history of country music. For the first time, boys from the South were brought in contact with others from all parts of the country. And of course, they brought with them the love for the music they liked best. One of the biggest hits of World War II has to be Elton Britt's immortal, There's a Star-Spangled Banner Waving Somewhere.
There's a Star-Spangled Banner waving somewhere, in a distant land so many miles away. Only Uncle Sam's great heroes get to go there, where I wish that I could also live someday. I'd see Lincoln, Custer, Washington, and Perry, Nathan Hale, and Colin Kelly, too. There's a Star-Spangled Banner waving somewhere, waving o'er the land of heroes brave and true.
But the nation never gave up hope, never doubted that good would triumph over evil. Not all the hits of World War II were sad. The folks back home still went out on Saturday night, and a lot of them put money in the jukebox to play this song from a Texan named Al Dexter.
Drinking beer in a cabaret, and was I having fun? Until one night she caught me right, and now I'm on the run. Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing, mama, lay that pistol down. She kicked out my windshield, she hit me over the head. She cussed and cried and said I'd lied and wished that I was dead. Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing, mama, lay that pistol down.
In 1944, Capitol Records signed a young man named Jack Guthrie. He made a few recordings and then was drafted. And while he was on an island in the Pacific, his first record was released.
Way down yonder in the Indian Nation, ride my pony on the reservation in those Oklahoma hills where I was born. Now way down yonder in the Indian Nation, the cowboy's life is my occupation in those Oklahoma hills where I was born.
When Jack Guthrie returned from the Army, he was amazed to find that he was a nationwide star because of this record, written by his cousin Woody Guthrie, the Oklahoma Hills. Jack Guthrie, like Jimmy Rogers, died of tuberculosis, but not without having first made country music history. The late 40s produced a lot of hits and greatly increased the popularity of country music.
Just bought me a great long ticket. I'm gonna use it at 4 p.m. So you can call your secret love and tell the news to him. You thought your little romance was on the strict QT. So if you want your freedom, PDQ, divorce me, COD. I won't be round to hear you cry. I'm Texas bound, and by, you can reach me down in Dallas, General Delivery. So if you want your freedom, PDQ, divorce me, COD.
The singer was Merle Travis, the year 1946. Then in 1948, another one of those singing cowboys got his first hit.
One has my name, the other has my heart. With one I'll remain, that's when my heartache starts.
Jimmy Wakely really struck it big in 1949 when Capitol Records teamed him with a pop singer named Margaret Whiting. Together they produced a hit that made country music history.
Seems we always have to slip around to be together, dear. Slipping around,
afraid we might be found. I know I can't forget you, and I've gotta have you near.
But we just have to slip around and live in constant fear.
Oh, you're tied up with someone else, and I'm all tied up too.
I know I've made mistakes, dear,
but I'm so in love with you.
I hope someday I'll find a way to bring you back to me. And I won't have to slip around.